I'm thinking how he starts. Okay, good morning and welcome to your favorite sports segment. I call it Keeping Score. You call it. I have with me in the building here the beautiful Jairo. Jairo, how are you doing this morning? You know, when you give me that, I feel so
You have to toast me well. You know, the toasting is longer.
Okay, Jairo, you know when you. When you fold your hair that way.
It's a sonnet.
Yeah, you know when you fold your hair that way, something trickles down to the body, and then when I look at it, I feel like, oh, I'm in heaven, and oh, man. When you whip your hair like that, yeah, I think it's back in front, and I have reached 14. What is your own answer?
Oh, thank you very much, Peace Samurai. Oh, sorry, Mike Masikena.
Okay, it's great to have you. This is Keeping Scores, and yeah. I won't speak about grassroots football, but let's leave it at that. All right, today on the show, on Keeping Scores, we're starting off with athletics, and we're talking about Chris Froome here. He says he's a double Tour de France champion, Chris Froome himself, and has urged athletics to follow cycling's lead and invest a lot of money in anti-doping. Now, it has been over blogs and newspapers and on the news. Lance Armstrong has been in the news for the issues he had with cycling. And then, of course, this guy has been a world champion, the Tour de France. I mean, I don't know. So when I was still, you know, looking up at the game of cycling, I saw this guy as somebody who was, you know, omnipotent. He had to be there. He had to win every tournament. He was up there and all. And then when he was indicted for doping charges, I really felt heartbroken. And now the point is this. They're saying athletics has issues. Now, a number of people have said, okay, we've had the issue of Justin Gatlin, of course, Marion Jones. Jai, we spoke about Marion Jones. I feel so heartbroken when I even called the name. Mm-mm. She was tall, had those long legs and all of that. But now, Chris Froome is saying that the same measures, strict and stringent measures that cycling takes, athletics should also follow that in that regard. Well, I think, yes, definitely, every sport needs to come down hard on doping. We don't want doping. You cannot give somebody an unfair and undue advantage. I mean, why would somebody take up some substances that have been banned? Okay, a number of them have said that they took these substances when they didn't know. The clear case comes to mind of Kolo Touré, the brother.
Exactly. That was exactly what I was about to talk about.
Okay.
Like, most of them, they don't know that they've taken substances in whatever they've taken. So I think they should tender justice with mercy in most situations.
That ignorance of the law is no excuse.
It's no excuse, but this is sports you're talking about. These people have to function. It's not like they take it before they embark on their mission or whatever they have to do. The tests are done like beforehand. Yep. So you can't use that to judge them completely and say, oh, this person must have been on dope while cycling or while running. No, it's too hard. The judgment is too hard.
Well, I'll personally say these guys are rich enough to have personal physicians. And so, yes, they should take responsibility. Before you take a medication, you should know what is in that medication. Now, there's something here. How has athletics reached this point? And a report here says that even in Russia, there's state-sponsored doping. What do you think about that? A state, a country supporting doping.
Well,
like, they do something. Stuff under the radar, and then they give their athletes performance-enhancing drugs, PEDs.
Whoa, no, that's not cool. That's
we have
cool
that report surfaced in Russia.
If they are contesting against themselves, it's understandable. But
yeah,
like having a competition with others, no, it's not cool. That's unfair.
They shouldn't even take it to compete amongst themselves.
Exactly.
That's what we're saying. Take out doping from sports. We need people to be on their normal level, on the same level that they expect everybody to be.
Yeah.
Okay, away from that, we have Andy Murray reaches the Rogers Cup third round. Not only him, of course, but we have Rafael Nadal. He has been on some sort of a slide. I mean, coming up, we do expect that Rafael Nadal is the one that is going to beat the record that Roger Federer has set. Okay, I love Roger Federer personally, and when Nadal came up, I was like, okay, this guy's going to do something and all of that. But then he has been on the decline. But in the Rogers Cup in Montreal, Canada, he has moved up to the next round. Andy Murray defeated Tommy Robredo. All right, he did that in two sets, 6-4 and 7-5. Of course, there were wins for other people. Rafael Nadal beat Sergei Stakhovsky. Yeah, of Ukraine. I like that guy. 7-6, 7-4, 6-3. While fourth seed Ikei and Nishikori went through with a 6-3, 6-3 win over Spain's Pablo Anduja. Okay, there were a lot of other wins also for people, but they move into the third round. And then let's see. I would want Nadal to do something at this tournament. Please, he is not done. He's not done. He's not done. And on transfer stories today, we have, I used to look at this midfielder and expected or thought that we have a future in Chelsea. But then, Oriol Romeo has moved to Southampton. And of course, he credits that move to the boss, Ronald Koeman, for making him move there. And I must say, we've spoken about money in football. What Southampton can afford, I think a team that's third place in Spain or maybe even Germany cannot afford. There's so much money in Premier League. And then getting a defensive midfielder of that stature, I think that's quite cool. Also, we have Kevin De Bruyne, who is, you know, being touted to Man City and all of others. And people have come out to say this guy is a great player. And then some people have seen him play and say, Mourinho, you made a mistake letting this guy go. You made a mistake letting this guy go. What do you think? Did Mourinho make a mistake with Kevin De Bruyne? You know, you can hit us up on social media. R2_TV, Twitter, Facebook, it's R2TV, Instagram, R2TV. Let's keep scores on this one. Yeah, I sound like somebody. Do you think Mourinho made a mistake with Kevin De Bruyne and now Oriol Romeo? Yeah, let's go up online and let's see that. Yesterday, we put up something about Mourinho and Eva Caminero. Now, we got some comments. Please keep them coming in because today, the Medical Association of England says they are standing by their colleagues against Mourinho, that he did something wrong, and now there are calls. There's a clamor, an online clamor for Mourinho to apologize publicly to Eva Caminero. Would you want Mourinho to apologize? So we'll keep this course as a rejoinder to the first course that we kept yesterday. And we say, do you think Mourinho should apologize? Jairo, what do you think?
Well, do you think Mourinho should apologize? If everybody's requesting for an apology, then he should just apologize. It will not take away from you.
If you know Mourinho, you know that, hey, man, he sticks to his guns, man.
His ego is, like, way up there. Well, it won't take anything away from you, Mourinho. Apologize and let it go.
It will. It's Mourinho.
It's Mourinho. So
yes.
There's nothing he can do about it, okay? His pride is just up there.
He's just up there.
Ooh, I have a scoop for you. Okay. Have you seen Dwayne Wade's jumpsuit?
Yeah, I saw it. What's up with you?
That threw me off balance. A man in a jumpsuit and this very low neckline V.
Jerry, stop taking your hand down there.
It's a V-neck.
Jerry, on TV.
It's a low neckline.
Jerry, stop doing that.
Okay, you do it. You do it. I'm trying to describe.
I ain't going
to
do that.
But what do you think about that outfit? Do you think he's trying to make a fashion statement? Okay, he's doing it. Do you think he's trying to make a fashion statement or something? I was tripped when I saw it. A lot of people had terrible comments about it, but I think it's daring. He just came out with his V-neck jumpsuit. Would you put on a jumpsuit?
No.
No.
Okay, on other transfer news, we also have Edin Dzeko. I mean, I actually love this guy, but then he's gone on a season-long loan to Roma. And I would say that's Manchester City's loss because this guy is someone that he's proven himself in the Premier League. Someone who gives you between 10, 15 goals, even with substitute appearances most of the time. He still gives you those 10, 15 goals every season. So I think it's a loss for Manchester City. Of course, they're going up against Chelsea this weekend. I am looking forward to it. Maybe I would start on the side of Man City and with my transmission head, Michael Achiume. Let's see if we can put a wager on this one. Right? Jairo, will you support me against Michael?
Against Mike?
Yeah. I want to put something now. It's Man City-Chelsea this weekend.
Ooh, that's one big one.
That's a big one, right?
Very big one.
That's a big one.
I'm just going to sit on the fence and watch you guys knock yourselves out.
Sit on the fence is not free.
What do you want me to do? How do you want to support you?
I want to go for Man City. You will support me.
He says
double or nothing. Like he will go double on whatever I do.
Whoa, man, that's really risky. What are you planning to give out?
But that will just be between us when we're done with this.
No problem.
Okay, I'll take up some few. Wow. He's now telling me that he's going to double anything
the
we
price.
Put.
Awesome.
Okay, all of you anti-Chelsea fans, so let's come together.
Yeah.
Let's so Michocho's mouth has been rubbing since.
Can I contribute?
Yes, that's what I said. You should support me.
No matter how little I contribute,
it's going to be double. Yeah, he's going to double of whatever we do.
But what if you lose?
If we lose, come on.
I don't like losing. No.
Okay, now I'll just take something interesting. Premier League myths. Yeah, Chelsea's defense, Stoke trolls, and more. I just want to take one that interests me. For all you Arsenal fans out there, let's go to this. It's about Mesut Ozil and says myth. The myth is that Mesut Ozil is lazy, and I believe in that myth a bit. You know, there are different shows on different stations where people talk about busting myths. So there's some things that we always believe, you know, that they're actually not true. You know, like, for example, when people say the sun rises in the east
and sets in the west. Nah, the earth revolves. And
the sun don't rise. That's a myth.
Anyway, from this view, it seems like the sun rises from the east and sets in the west.
Okay, but then let me just wash over this. Accusations of laziness have dogged the Arsenal midfielder Mesut Ozil ever since he arrived in the Premier League. Now, from Real Madrid 2 seasons ago, as recently as March, former Man U player
Scholes said he was going through motions. He was just walking around. But when compared to other top attacking midfielders playing for the last season's top six finishers, the German international, while in no way the most energetic, was hardly the most inactive in terms of sprinting around the pitch and winning the ball back from opposition. That means that by stats, Mesut Ozil is not the laziest midfielder. He's not even amongst the lowest three laziest midfielder. From what I see here, he's at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's 6 out of 12. Whoa. We're talking about the top midfielders in the Premier League. Mesut Ozil has covered more ground. He has an average of 55 sprints per every 90 minutes. Much better than Sami Nasri. Much better than Oscar in Chelsea. Oscar goes for 50. Sami Nasri goes for 52. Juan Mata goes for 49. And David Silva goes for 48. Okay, wow. Busting that myth, and also the sun doesn't really rise in the east and set in the west.
It's really amazing how the people that don't play football would say, oh, this is the laziest myth.
Yeah, I also say
go run around the pitch for one, two times.
Ozil is lazy, I play football.
Nah. He's lazy. And nobody's lazy, I play football.
Okay, we have come to the end of Keeping Scores. How does he end it? Please, remind me. How does he end it?
It's like a
rap. Yeah, remember, keep playing.
Keep winning.
Keep winning.
Yeah.
And we will keep. Keeping the scores.